Good morning, everyone. It's Miss Elizabeth, and I am here with another musical morning. I have an exciting craft project for us today. But first, we're going to sing our hello song. You ready? Children, children, hello, children, how are you today? Children, children, hello, children, come, let's sing and play. Children, children, hello, children, how are you today? Children, children, hello, children, come, let's sing and play. Well, I have something very special I'm going to make you. It's a special kind of accessory that they may have used during the Renaissance to dance. Sometimes at home we'll dance with scarves, or we'll just dance by ourselves. But in the Renaissance, they would have long streamers that they might dance with. So today, we're going to make one. So come on over here, and I'll show you what you need. It's so simple. All you need is a circle and some ribbon. So for me to make the circles, the cheapest and easiest thing that I've ever found is these are just shower curtain holders. So they just make little circles. You can get expensive ones, but these are like 99 cents from the dollar store for 10 of them. So it's a great deal. We're just gonna use one right now. And then for ribbon, you can also go to the dollar store and get some of the Christmas ribbon or the things. But this is what I found. Look, at Michael's, I found something called ribbon scraps. And it has all sorts of different colors, which I thought would be really fun for the Renaissance. Now this is a very, very easy craft. All you have to do, look at all this ribbon, is pick out your favorite ribbon, and you're gonna unwind it, and you want it to be just about as long as your body, as long as your, they call this your wingspan, how far apart your arms are. And then you fold it up like this until you make a little loop. And you take the loop end, and you put it inside the circle. And see my loop? I'm gonna put all of the rest of it through the loop. That's called threading it through. Oop, ba-doop, ba-doop. There it goes. I pull it nice and tight. Oh, look, I have the first part of my ribbon dancer. And then I'm gonna do it with some more colors. You can do all the same color, or you can do lots of different colors. You can do theme, like I thought about doing maybe a Halloween theme because it's October right now, but I decided I wanted to do a lot of colors like the Renaissance. But here I made another one. I spread it out. I made a little loop. I put the loop inside the hole. And then I, we call it thread the rest of it through. And pull it really tight. And then we can squish them together. Now I have two. Let's see what other color. Oh, here's a pretty gold one. I think I'll use that. So I spread it out. Fold it over, find my loop, put the loop through the hole, thread it through, and pull it tight. You can do as many of these as you want. I think I might do three more. Oh, here's this one's kind of pretty. It's red and green. It looks like maybe a Christmas ribbon. Fold it over. Make my loop, bring it through, pull it tight. Sometimes they come a little loose after you've pulled them tight. At the end, if you want to, you can get a grown-up to help you, and maybe you can put some super glue or hot glue there, and that makes it a little bit better. I'm gonna make two more. Let's see, what color should I use? Oh, this is a pretty one. It's sort of silver and gold. Fold it over, find my loop, put it in, thread it through. Ooh, pull it tight. Oh, this is really looking pretty. One more, I need a bright color. Oh, this green, look at that. I'm going to fold it over, make my loop, put the loop inside, thread it through, This is a really good thing to practice. If you can't figure it out right away, you can have a grown-up help you, but it would be good for you to practice it at home and try it out and see if you can figure out how to do it. There's a lot of tricky finger movement to make it work. Pull it tight. Oh my goodness, this is my ribbon dancer. Now here we go, I'll show you some pretty things you can do with it. So you can make it go in a big circle. I like to make mine go kind of sideways and back and forth. You can swirl it around you in a circle like this, or it can make the circle around you. You can make it bounce up and down. You can make it shake really fast. You can take it down and let it be like a snake in the grass. All kinds of things. So I'm gonna play a little bit of Renaissance music for you. And if you have your ribbon dancer with you, you can dance with it. If you have a scarf with you, you can dance with that. And if you want to pause the video until your ribbon dancer is finished, then you can do that too, and then push play, and we can dance together with our ribbon dancers. I'm gonna push play. Okay, here comes, this is called Kemp's Jig, and our lute player has been playing this at our concerts this week. You can take some glue and just glue where those little knots are. That'll make it stay a little bit more secure. But you can make one for each hand. You can use it as a little, peekaboo spaghetti monster thing. It's very exciting. You can do lots of things with this. But I hope that you will come and see our concert this fall. It's all about the Renaissance. We've got way more fun than this. And that's all I have for you today. Thank you very much. Have a good morning. Bye.